Hi everybody and welcome back to Coding is Easy. Today I'm just going to do a bit of a beginner tutorial really. Somebody asked me yesterday how to actually get a Laravel project into GitHub or Bitbucket. I think a lot of people just expect you to know how to do this. I know when I first did it a few years back I had a bit of trouble on how to do it. So I'm just going to go through how to add an existing Laravel or PHP project to GitHub or Bitbucket. So if you already know how to do that, then this video is probably not for you, but if you want to learn how to do it, then stay tuned. So basically I've just set up a brand new GitHub account just to show how to do this. So what I've done so far is just gone to the Laravel docs, created a brand new Laravel application. So this is just exactly how you get it, the blog example. I'm just going to show you how to put this straight onto GitHub. So the first thing that I'd suggest to do is to add your SSH key to GitHub, because it just saves you putting in, I don't know if you've ever used Git before, but if you don't put your SSH key in, you have to put your GitHub username and password in every single time you do a pull or a push. So by putting your SSH key in, you literally can just do git push and it will push your changes. So to do this, if you go to settings and then SSH, and then I literally just did a Google search for how to copy SSH key on Mac. I think that I'm pretty sure that the Linux one is exactly the same. So it's just this command here, this pbcopy, which will copy your SSH key to the clipboard. If you've not got an SSH key yet, there's loads of stuff on Google on how to generate it. I think it's literally like one or two commands. But I can do another video on that if anyone needs me to do that. So what you do then is take this command and just paste it into your, you can do this anywhere, it'll work anywhere. So you just do, so that's copied my SSH key to the clipboard. And then if you go back into GitHub and new SSH key, if you just put, you can put anything for the title, it's just so that you know what SSH key links with what device, because that goes on your machine. So just paste that command V to paste it in and then add. Because I've got this SSH key on my personal GitHub, it won't let me add it to this second account. So I'm gonna have to work around this in another way, but for you it should just work straight away if you've not already got an SSH key on another account. So I'll have to do an extra step to add mine to the repository, but I'll let you know what I'm doing when I get to that. So then what you want to do is go back to the home page and then create repository, which is here on the left. I think you can also get to it from this plus here, so you can do new repository. So I'm literally just going to call it test. I'll call it blog because that's what the app is called. I'm just going to leave it as public, but if you, since we did that SSH key, you would be able, actually I'll do it as a private, just so that it's the same as what you would be doing. So yeah, if we create that now. So then when you create the repository, it gives you some commands that you can use to generate, to add your project into this repository. So what we're going to be looking at is this second block of code here, because we've already got an existing project, even though we've just started it. you might have it already half built. Right, so this is the code that we need. The first thing that we're gonna have to do is go into the folder where our project is. So in mine it's just called blog. Just do an ls to make sure I'm in the right folder. Yep. So what we do then is do git init, which just initializes the git repository, a blank one in our project. So it's told us that it's initialized an empty git repository. And then what we do then is do git add dot, which will add everything. It will stage every file in the project to go into this repo, except for anything in the git ignore, which I'll talk about in a second. So what we need to do is do so that's just a commit message. So it's git commit and then minus m is the message. So I'm just putting init because it's the first initial commit. So these are all the files that it's going to be adding. It's useful just to look through this and make sure you've got no sensitive files that you want to put in. It's pretty cool with Laravel because it automatically, if you do have a .env file with sensitive variables in it, it'll automatically ignore that, so it won't put it in your repository, which is good for security. So then if we do, once we've done that, we can go back to this code, copy this first line, which will add the remote origin. And then just copy this one, which will push what we've got now to master. Yeah, so it's asking me for my username. So if you've done that SSH bit that I showed you at the start, you won't have to do this. It'll literally just work without you having to put this in every time. So now if we go into our repository, we should be able to see the code. Yeah, so it's put that in for us. And this is just the default README that you get with Laravel. So literally that's as simple as it is. It's exactly the same if you want to do this on Bitbucket as well. So what I'm going to do is just create a repository on Bitbucket. And then you literally just get the same commands at the bottom, which you can use exactly how I showed you on GitHub. So I just thought I'd let you know. And you can add your SSH key and all that, just exactly the same as you do on GitHub. So it's pretty simple. And then I'll just show you quickly how to push new changes. So if you make, I'll just make any old, I'll just put a line. So then if you do git, once you've done your changes, if you do git status, you'll see that that file has changed. Then if you do git add dot to add all the files that you've changed, and then git commit minus m, and then your message. Then you should just be able to do git push from then on. So then if you refresh this now, you'll see that on this app folder it's been changed sooner than the rest of it. If you go on commits, you'll see that latest commit is there as well. I'm going to do another video on how to actually deploy a Laravel project to Forge. If that's something that you'd like me to do, just let me know in the comments and I'll try and get that done as soon as I can. Hopefully that helped. If you've got any questions about this, I know it's quite a lot to take in a short amount of time if you're new to programming. So if you've got any questions, just put it in the comments and I'll reply to every comment. Hopefully that helped some of you. If it did, don't forget to subscribe. I'm going to try and do at least one video a week from now on. Thanks for watching.